Hello everyone, this is a LangChain tips video looking at how to save tokens and speed up your code. We're going to be looking at FakeList LLM and LangChain cache. FakeList LLM, firstly, from LangChain LLMS.fake, import FakeList LLM. What you need to do is set responses equal to a list where you've got action and input. Action is Python REPL action, and the input is your fake calculation or your fake response. So responses equals responses. You have to pass in this for it to work. So what we're really doing is we're substituting FakeList LLM instead of our actual LLM. So what it does is it allows you to run the code as if you were calling an LLM, but you just get back the answer that you need anyway to proceed with the rest of your code. So if we look at the actual code, you can see here we've got fake, which will give us 4.42. And had we run the real code and incurred cost of tokens, we would also have got the same answer. So once we know what the answer is, we can just put in a fake. It's basically a placeholder so that when you're ready, you can just comment out a fake, uncomment the real, and then your LLM is equal to this LLM instead of it being equal to that LLM. So really it's just this line and this line are different. And then let's look at LangChain cache. What that enables you to do is memorize the response such that if you call the same question, you'll get the answer from the cache instead of making another call. From langchain.cache, import in memory cache, langchain.llm underscore cache equals in memory cache. So you're instantiating a instance of that class. So here we're just saying predict, tell me a joke. The first time it's not yet in cache, so it should take longer. This is from the LangChain documentation. The second time it is in cache, so it goes faster. And they've got the timings here, so you can see the first time they call it is calling the large language model, and we've got wait time 4.8 seconds. Second time they call it, so it's getting the result from the cache, 1.76 milliseconds. So that's not to be sniffed at. So there we go, quick overview of using cache and also using a fake LLM. So the fake LLM, you really just use that whilst you're developing to provide you with the answer that you need to proceed with the rest of your code. Think monkey patch in PyTest or monkey patch in mock in PyTest. So there we go. Don't forget to cache your results if you're going to be testing and you're just going to be getting the same answer and over and over again. So thanks for watching, and I'll be back with some more tips very soon.